Thank you so much for having me. I'm very excited to be here talking to you about branding today and how you can incorporate your personal brand into your career. And so I want this to be a super interactive session, so my worst nightmare is to stand up here and talk to you for an hour. So I want it to be interactive. I want you guys to raise questions, have conversations, shout out answers. And so the more that we interact, the better, the more fun it'll be for all of us.
Companies that are in alignment with who you are as a person.
The more you do that, the happier you're going to be in your careers and your personal lives, is you want that all to be consistent and meshing together. And so being truly authentic, and sometimes that takes some really time to sit back and think through things, but making sure that you're being authentic and not one thing one place and one thing another place. Then communicating your brand story. So how we have so many vehicles now with social media and all of these things. So making sure that what you're putting out into the world, whether that be your post or a post that you're sharing, article, is that consistent with your brand message and what you want to be putting out into the world? And then the last part is really reevaluating and adjusting your brand, taking that time to self-reflect and then realign your brand. What your brand is today is not necessarily going to be your brand 10 years from now or 4 years from now. So as you develop through your educational career, through your career in life, through your personal journey as far as family and different things that you experience, your brand is going to change. And so it's you need to be constantly kind of reevaluating and retooling it. So as we start to define the purpose through our values and strengths, your personal brand is really what makes you unique. And so we're going to spend some time on that tonight, on what makes you unique, your talents, the treasures you bring to the world, your personality, all of the pieces about you that you love, and really check in on those. So I want you first to flip over one of your papers and take a little bit of time. I'll give you 2 minutes and just go through these questions, asking yourself, what are some talents that you possess? What are you really passionate about? What gets you excited? What are you doing or talking about? What do you enjoy doing or talking about? What do others seek out in expertise from you? And then how do you want to make a difference in the world? So take 2 minutes on that. I'll set the timer. Everybody have a few notes jotted? We're going to use these as we go. So I want you to flip over and take out this sheet of paper. And we're going to go through kind of a values exercise, and then we will get into the rest of the pieces of this worksheet. But to start off, and here's a list of some values. Now, this is not an exhaustive list, so if your favorite value in the world is not on this list, still write it down. It doesn't have to be on this list. This is just to get the juices flowing. But I want you to write down 3 to 5 values that really you feel represent who you are as a person, what you want to put out in the world, and what is important to you. So take a minute or two and work on that, writing those down in that first column of the worksheet. Right.
So when you wake up in the morning, if you're like, I'm going to have the best day ever, what are the things that are going on that day that you're getting to do or that just really get you excited? And make a little list of those. Then what are you passionate about? And then what inspires and motivates you? Are there people, or are there activities, or are there things, organizations that motivate you? List those there, and then we'll get on to the second part once you have those. So take a few minutes and come up on each of those calls. Another minute. If anyone's getting stuck on things, just kind of go with your initial gut reaction. Don't overthink it. I think you tend to overthink things a lot often. And so just put kind of your immediate reactions. So when you've got these four columns filled out, what I want you to do is look across all four columns and look at areas where they overlap. Are there common themes that kind of flow throughout all four of these columns? Is there something that you can kind of tie together that is kind of that thread that runs through it? And if there is, you know, maybe circle the things that you feel like kind of all thread together as a common theme. And then, what is the contribution and impact? Are there some things that stand out as far as this is a contribution to the world or an impact that I want to make in the world that is kind of showing up as a theme? And then we're going to start working on making our statement.
Perseverance.
Perseverance, that's a good one. Good, those are some great ones, you guys. So here's just, as we start to work through setting up our statement, you want it to be simple. You don't want it to be overcomplicated, over flowery. You want it to be a simple, understandable statement. These are just some great examples of ones that other people have done. But really take those themes that are in your four columns and work on just crafting a very simple, short sentence that kind of holds those important things together as far as your values, what you're passionate about, what you want to put out into the world. So this one I'll do a minute. Can't just pull this one off the cuff. More seconds to kind of wrap it up. Remember, this does not have to be your perfect final version. It's going to be your draft, your very rough draft. And it'll change 100 times. Put your brand out there are really getting you back the rewards that you want from that.
And then creating networking advantages. You know, if you have a very consistent brand message out there, you're going to end up aligning with groups, with different organizations that have similar values and alignment with what you have in your brand. And that's just going to be a more positive experience with you in building those networks. So now we're going to have a little group discussion. So get in kind of your little pods. And what I want you to do is I want you to ask your group members their experience or first impressions of you. Some of you are probably sitting with people that you've never met before. Some of you are probably sitting with old friends. But just ask, what was your first impression of me? If you knew absolutely nothing about me, what would you say was your first impression? Just from how I walked in the room, how I sat down. So ask that and share. Share some insights about your brand exercise. If you got some like aha moment when you were writing things down and spending a little time thinking about your values, share some of that with your peers in your group. And then if you feel comfortable and brave enough, share your draft of your brand statement and get some feedback. Okay? So get in your little clusters, I'd say three or four.
You know, that piece to be consistent.
in really what the message is at.
And this includes any content that you share. You know, if you read articles that you think are interesting and you repost it or something, you want those to be consistent with kind of what your brand message is as well. Then, is the media platform relevant for your target audience? You know, yes, employers might check your Instagram. Probably not your TikTok, but I don't know that anybody your guys' age uses Facebook anymore. It's just me. But LinkedIn is the one that we're going to talk about as we get into the evening. And really, that is where all of your recruiters are going, all of your talent acquisition managers are going. That's what we're looking at primarily. But some of the more creative positions and stuff, they will ask for your portfolio, they'll ask for like your Instagram, because they want to do that due diligence as well. So be thoughtful about where you're putting what. And then, what activities, meetings, professional events are you engaged in, and what is your involvement? You know, make sure this is consistent with you. And an example, so I'm very involved in my sorority alumni group, but I'm a talent acquisition manager. So a lot of my values and my why is really connecting people with great careers and making those relationships and building that. So if I'm sitting on my executive team of my sorority and my involvement is as the treasurer, you know, that's probably not terribly consistent with me as a person and not authentic to my brand and my vision of what I want to put out into the world. And so, and it's probably not leveraging my talents very well. And so I might be better in a membership position or something like that where I'm making those connections. And so you want to think through kind of how you show up in the different groups and activities that you're involved in. And then, what is your style and appearance convey to others? I work for a fashion company, so, you know, it definitely is ingrained in you, but that's your first impression, right? When somebody walks in the door, that's one of the things that kind of gauges in your mind of what your first impression is. And there is no wrong style. I mean, it's show up as your authentic self, and so it doesn't mean you have to be in heels and a suit, or, you know, there's some things that might be more appropriate for certain occasions than others, but really, you want your appearance to be reflective of who you are as a person and to have that be your authentic self. And frankly, if you are in an organization or a group that is not accepting you for, you know, who you are and who you show up with, that's probably not the best place to be. You are going to be a happy, more joyful person if you are in a place that is accepting of who you are and what your style is and what you bring to the table as far as your talents and treasures. What feedback do you have from your personal network, mentors, and peers? So again, kind of circling back to that information that you received from all of the people out there, and where do you need to make some adjustments and changes? All right. So the next part is really building that brand score. So we've got our baseline statement that we've been working on. And then these are just kind of the writing prompts that are going to help you build the story of what makes you unique, what do you want to educate, who do you want to educate about your brand. So as we talked about it, different audiences, it could be fellow students in a classroom, it could be people in an organization that you work with, it could be a volunteer group that you are associated with, it could be a potential employer, it could be your family, you know, whoever it is that you really want to educate about your brand, gear your messaging and your story towards that. And then, what do you want your brand to really accomplish? So this is, are you going out and getting a job? Are you trying to get accepted into this volunteer group that you want to work with? You know, are you running for an office in an organization that you are associated with? So you really want to align that with what you want to accomplish. So have that focus of, here's the goal, and how does my brand message really communicate to that goal? And then you're going to build the story around that. So you can take that worksheet and use that as your homework takeaway. And then as you start to really craft that story about you, you want it to be simple and clear with some real standout details. Think about key events that have shaped you in your life. Somebody back there talked about perseverance earlier. And, you know, what are the things in your life that caused you to have perseverance? What were those occasions that you were like, oh, I had to persevere through this? You know, and really use those key points and those key events in your life to start to tell the story and how you want to make a difference in the world. How are you going to take that perseverance and put something good out into the world and accomplish something with that? So think about those key elements. Then be true to your personality and voice. It's a powerful way to establish credibility. The more authentic you are, the more you are going to come across to other people as trustworthy, and they are going to feel more comfortable building a connection with you. And so really building that credibility, that reputation that you have, and then fostering those really deep connections. And then a structured story. So it's back to creative writing 101. It's really doing a personal narrative of your life and your career to this point. And then it's okay to be aspirational too. It doesn't have to be, this is what I've done to this point, but you can also weave in there what you want to do and how you want to see that showing up in the future. And once you have that story kind of put together, that is something that you are going to use as a tool. So some of you I have spoken with when we went through mock interviewing, and one of the things that I talked about was, you know, tapping into some of those stories when somebody asks you a question about your strengths or asks you a question about a time that you had to get through a hard situation. This is going to give you that tool to lean back on and go, I know what my values are. I know what my why is, and this is how I can communicate this in an interview. Or, you know, meeting somebody for the first time and you want them to know something about you. So this is a real tool that you can use as you start to craft that story. Then being authentic in the brand. I know I've said this a lot tonight, but it is just super important because this is what's going to bring you joy and bring you happiness and bring you satisfaction in your life, is really to have that in alignment. So again, organizations you're involved in, the hobbies and activities, philanthropic work, environment in your home, creating your office space or your home space. You know, somebody walks into your home and they get a sense of who you are as a person, right? And so you want that all to be very consistent. And then your personal interactions. You know, if you say you're the kindest person in the world and you want to put kindness out there, and then you turn around and you're stabbing somebody in the back, that's probably not consistent with your brand message. And so really paying attention to how you're showing up in different situations. Okay, then communicating your brand. So as we start to get into this, how you're putting this out into the world, your brand voice, you have a voice and a tone with it, just like I'm up here speaking and I have a voice and a tone, and so you get some sense of something about me from my voice and tone. Are you funny? Are you empathetic? Are you authoritative? What is it that you want to put across as far as your messaging? And then having that voice and tone represent that in your brand. Visual elements, what emotions do things evoke? Colors, fonts, images. We saw that with the different logos of the companies and things. How does that make you feel? This is where, as you start to put together things, and we will be talking about LinkedIn, but really, what are the colors you're using? What kinds of, you don't have a lot of font options on LinkedIn, but, you know, as you like do presentations or things like that, do you have some consistent things that really are better representative of you and who you are as a person? Balancing authenticity and aspirations now and in the future. Again, it's really good to stay grounded in where you are and focus on that, but also have some aspirational pieces that you can share and express to people so they know where you want to go. And then personal website portfolio. This can be a great way, a blog, to communicate kind of your larger brand story. You know, Instagram, LinkedIn, you've got little places where you can kind of sprinkle things in. But these are also better, you know, ways that you can kind of expand that story and share and put that on your resume. So, putting your brand to work on LinkedIn. And I'm not going to take credit for these slides because my wonderful colleague Laura put these together and she is the expert in all things LinkedIn. So tap into her if you've got any questions. LinkedIn has millions of members. So that is one of the reasons why you would even want to be on LinkedIn. And I know, how many of you are freshmen? So just kind of starting out, probably haven't really explored LinkedIn a whole lot. But this is, and when my kids were in college, I had a competition with them with how many connections we could make, who had the most connections. And so this is just a great way to start building your network for career opportunities, for all kinds of networking. You might need a mentor, you might need information on some project you're working on, but this is a great way to start building those relationships. So millions of members in it. It shows up on all the top Google searches. It's packed with all kinds of invaluable resources. They've got training. So some of the key things that you really want to do is you want a profile picture. 14 times more likely to get picked up by a recruiter or somebody searching if you've got a photo. So getting a photo out there and have it be one that's representative of you. You know, don't post your cat or, you know, whatever it is. Just have a nice professional picture. It doesn't have to be a professional headshot, but you can take a nice picture that is representative of you and who you are and have that up there. Background images, this is a great place where you can express kind of that color, any kinds of objects and things that you really like. We're very blessed that Kendra Scott gives us lots of wonderful backgrounds that we can utilize. So as you get working for a company, they will likely have some templates that you can use. Name and headline. You want obviously people to know who you are, and so you want your name and put your legal name up there, and then also really inserting your pronouns and letting people know about how you would like to be addressed. Updating your headline with your current position or customizing the section with anything that you're working on, but keep it really succinct. So this is a great place for that one-liner sentence that you've been working on to go. Is in kind of that headline. Basic elements of a LinkedIn profile. So first you've got that top portion where we have Laura, and now this is the beginning of her about. And so this is really where you can start to build on that brand story. And as you get with this pink worksheet and get your homework done, this is where you can add in kind of that expanded story. What's going on, why you show up the way that you show up, and what you want to do. And then have a call to action in it. So, you know, if you're out looking for a job and it's in a specific area or something, put a call to action at the end of, hey, if anyone has any leads in a position in this, or I'm a very interested and enthusiastic student who would like to get some experience in this. If you have connections, please link with me. You know, give the reader something to do at the end of it. Any questions on that? Okay. Then we have a skills section, and so this is really where you started to list some of your talents and unique abilities about you. This is where you want to make sure that they show up. Those are skills that people are looking for. And so you want to be able to showcase those, and recruiters can search on those. And so getting all of your different skills, and there's a million of them in LinkedIn, and you just start typing and they'll pop up. So really getting those. And then endorsements. So once you put skills up there, your connections can endorse you and say, yes, Kristin Carpenter, she's a good recruiter, so they endorse me. And so you end up having endorsements. So that elevates your profile and allows people to see that, oh, they're not just saying they have that experience. Seven other people are saying they have that experience. And so that really validates the strengths that you're putting out there and saying that you have. Now, this is where you want to build your network, because only first degree connections can endorse you. So if I'm not connected to you, I can't say, oh, you were wonderful, and yes, you have this skill. So that's where you really want to build those connections. And then recommendations. This is something where, colleagues that you've worked with, mentors in school, friends that have worked with you in some capacity, whether it be on a committee or whatever, they can write a review for you and give you a recommendation. And so this is a great place to validate your brand. You're putting out your brand message. These people that you know are now saying, yes, this is an accurate depiction of who they are as a person. And so this is a great place where you can have that consistency between what others are seeing of you and what you're putting out there. And so this is a great place. Also, you can give recommendations. And so you also can see when you go on somebody's profile what recommendations they've given. So you want to be consistent when you're giving a recommendation too, that you are staying true to kind of who your brand voice is. Okay, and then just additional elements on LinkedIn that can be helpful, different licenses and certifications that you pick up along the way in your educational career, any volunteering opportunities that you are involved in. You know, this is a great way, as we talk about kindness and serving and giving back, that we've had some themes running through the room, that you can showcase those and really double down on the fact that that's what you want to be putting out into the world. And then any honors or awards that you receive are great to have in there as well. Okay, and then also, just activities. So when you post or repost or share an article or share a video on LinkedIn, all of that activity is stored and people that come and visit your page can see that. And so making sure that you're, one, reading things before you reshare them, because sometimes you might reshare something and then when you really go back and read it, you're like, oh my gosh, this is not consistent with my brand message. So really making sure that the things that you share, even if you did not write it, but if you're sharing something, that those are also consistent with your brand message. And a good way to reinforce your brand story, because if you're talking about, you know, some kind of philanthropic thing that you are interested in and you reshare some articles about that or how that's shown up in the news or what they're doing or you're following them and they have done, you know, some new thing and you shared that, that's great for just showing your continued interest in that organization. And then lastly, another piece of homework is really getting started on your best practices. And so going back and completing your profile, doing your story, and you're finishing polishing up your statements, and really getting that into your profile as your first impression, and starting to build that network, sharing updates with all of the people that you're networked with, following companies that you're interested in, and then engaging. Be responsive. You know, don't just put your profile up there and then never touch it, never do anything with it. You know, it just looks
dry and sad then. You want to be involved in sharing information, commenting back, and being an engaged member of the community. And then lastly, to wrap up the evening, and again, the most important part is really taking that time and self-reflecting. Again, your brand statement that you come up with in the next few days is going to change over your career in school, your career outside of school, your lifetime. And so really just carving out that time, whether it be on an annual basis or when some big change in your life has happened, but really taking that time to sit down and reflect on, is this still in alignment with what I want going forward? Because it will change many times throughout your life, and it's important to take that time and really reflect on that so that you do remain consistent on what you're putting out into the world. And that's all I have for you.